But how many of you read the Wall Street Journal? Anybody read the Wall Street Journal? Okay, Friday, last Friday, the editorial is just as exciting as you can have it. It's all about the city of brotherly love in Philadelphia. And Philadelphia has a forfeiture law ordinance. I don't know what it is, but it's the city of Philadelphia. And the fact situation that brings this editorial to light is a young guy of 22 years old is selling dope out of his daddy's house. And he sells the dope, and he gets caught. And so he's arrested, and he's put in a diversion program, and everything's happy. And one bright day, his daddy gets a notice of seizure of his house. And it's like, now think about it. This is a gold mine, a gold mine. You can seize a house, not a vehicle. They seize the house. And it goes on to say that there's no judiciary involved. It all ends up in the office building of City Hall in room 457, where the police department and the city attorneys, all acting civilly, make you, the defendant, prove your innocence. And then it goes on to say, in 2012, the city of Philadelphia filed 8,000 forfeiture complaints. Their average recovery was $550 a pop. That's $4 million. The forfeiture fund, since it was, the forfeiture law, since it was instituted, has funded the city $65 million. And there's an incentive for forfeiture because what it says, if the police seize, the police department gets to keep all the money.